Hey guys, in a previous video I showed you several ways you can add Bluetooth to an old pair of speakers and make them wireless. Long story short, you can either use a cheap Chinese Bluetooth receiver like this one, or if you prefer, you can get a brand name Bluetooth module like this one by Logitech. However, I recently found out that there is another type of Bluetooth receiver, so I went ahead and bought one to see if it's any good. The price was about $9 with shipping included. This particular Bluetooth receiver is made specifically for old iPod speaker docks, like this JBL unit that I got secondhand for about $10. The module does not work with every single speaker dock, but there is a compatibility list on the product page. I'm gonna leave a link in the video description. Anyway, what is neat about this module is that it plugs directly into the iPod connector. It doesn't need external power, and it doesn't matter if your speaker has an auxiliary input socket. You plug it in, and it goes into pairing mode straight away. It popped up in the Bluetooth menu of my phone, I tapped on it, and boom, they were connected.
Connected.
Then I put on some music to hear what the sound was like, and it was okay. There is the familiar quiet beeping that you can hear on cheap Bluetooth speakers, but it's not an issue if there's music playing. I found out that I could use the speaker's remote control to change songs. The play pause button also works. The volume control buttons change the volume level of the speaker, not of your phone, but that is to be expected, I think. Now, this is supposed to be a Bluetooth 5 device, so the range should be pretty good. To test this, I took the speaker outside and went as far out in the yard as I could. I used an app to tell me the Bluetooth signal strength, and at 20 meters, I was getting a solid 80%. Signal was at 50% at 40 meters. Of course, this is not a super realistic or practical test, but it shows that the range of this receiver is excellent. What is not excellent is the latency, meaning that there is a small delay in the sound. All Bluetooth speakers have some latency. It's normal, and you don't notice it with music. But if you are watching video, it could be annoying. Overall, I think that this is a nice little gadget. It works as expected, and for just a few bucks, you can bring an old iPod speaker back to life instead of throwing it in the garbage. If you want to get one, I'm gonna leave a link in the video description. Thanks for watching, and subscribe to my channel to never miss any of my future videos.